So guys, here you have some more questions regarding kinetic theory of gases. So that is on. There is some liquid in a closed bottle. Okay, he is asking about, there is some liquid, yeah, in a closed bottle. The amount of liquid is continuously decreasing. The vapor in the remaining part is, that means here you have a container like this. Okay, so you have a liquid at this volume. So you have this much of liquid in it. So every time, this is at instant time t1. When you see at time instant t2, then it should be, then it may be at this level. Okay, so the remaining part is filled with vapor. Okay, so there is some liquid in a closed bottle. The amount of liquid is continuously decreasing. The vapor in the remaining part is, so okay, so here from the options, there will be no vapor is a not a good option. Why? Because the amount of liquid is decreasing, so there must be a vapor in it. And the next one, so must be saturated or may be saturated. May be is also wrong option. So here must be saturated and must be unsaturated, these two are the options you have to imagine. Okay, must be unsaturated, that means why? Because must unsaturation state. Okay, unsaturation state. So here the option is this one, it's okay. So why? So here amount of liquid is decreases with time. Okay, then vapor is present in this case. So that case should be tells about unsaturation state. Okay, so here is the second question. There is some liquid in a closed bottle. The amount of liquid is remains constant as time passes. When time is passes, there is no vapor in it. Okay, so the every time you see is at every time the bottle contains same liquid. So that must be in saturation state. Okay, so when time passes, the liquid constantly, that means it doesn't have any change in its part. In its part of volume. Okay, so that is the state of saturated state. So from these two questions you clear your doubts. Okay, so vapor is injected at a uniform rate in a closed vessel which has initially evacuated the pressure in the vessel. Okay, so take this case. Okay, why? Because here vapor is increases from from first case to another case. Okay, when time passes, vapor is increases. So here we can assume says vapor is injected at a uniform rate. Okay, so in a closed vessel which has initially evacuated the pressure in the vessel will be, so here first it seems to be when it is unsaturation state. Okay, that means when the vapor is injected in it, here you have a pressure change. Okay, so the pressure is constantly increases when you have a unsaturation state. When you reaches to saturated state, then pressure, this vapor injection is getting decreases. Okay, when it goes to saturation state. Okay, then pressure must be constant at the saturation state. So here first increases pressure and then becomes constant. Okay, in this case, that's it. And then second one, a vessel A has a volume V which and a vessel B has volume 2V. So A has a volume V and B vessel has a volume 2V. both contain some water which has constant volume. That means here you have a V volume container, here you have a 2V volume container, but you have both contain some water which has a constant volume. That means here how much volume it contains water, for suppose it should it to be V, here also that much amount of water it contains. So definitely pressure in the space above water is PA for vessel A and PB for vessel B. So those both are equal, PA equal to PB. Why? Because here volume is constant. Okay, from the process of isochoric process. Okay, that's it. Okay, then continue to read about theory. Okay, then do number of more MCQs, then only you can improve your subject. Okay, and in case of exam also, in fraction of seconds you can get the right option. Okay, so that's more important in case of exam. You have to research in this much at exam, that makes you less time for getting good score. Okay, so this much research do at this time only, then there, that means at exam you can crack within seconds for better options in physics. Okay, so definitely you crack the exam, so don't worry about it. Just brush up your whole formulas and theory, some theory behind the formulas. Okay, so you have in RMS speed values like this. Okay, you have the formula, you know the formula, but here just missed this term, root mean square value or mean square value, then you got the wrong option as like this. Okay, so that's the cases. Okay, thank you.